sometimes it's there as well. Regarding NAT, where to enable NAT, carrier credit NAT or LSM. LSM means large scale NAT, and it's the same thing as CDN. So this is practically the case where everybody are using them today, and then it's about the case by case. The ISP service is always a good thing for where to put the large scale NAT in the network then. So NAT 444 is an example here. Here in the lower part of the picture, you see the home users or small businesses, and their CVE one is doing this for performing the first level of NAT. And then you have something which is pretty new to many of the people, is IP shared addresses or ISP shared addresses. So you're sharing IP addresses amongst the service providers. So today, if I take my DSL router at home, I know that I have a unique IPv4 address. This is globally unique on my outbound interface, and that's routable throughout the internet. But in the case of ISP shared addresses, you could have the same IP address as you could have with another operator offering the same service. But then you have to be extra careful not to leak those routes, because they should not be routable in the backbone of the network or other parts of the internet, because they could win the case in that case. But it's kind of extending the amount of IPv4 addresses in the network by just having overlapping even on that link, which is between the CPE device and the aggregation part of the server port network. And then you would do the second level of NAT at the core of the network. I am a router sales guy. I could say, yes, we have such a huge device that can do whatever kind of NAT function, and it scales to unlimited number of sessions. And it's always available, etc. But there's also the fact that I haven't seen that big NAT devices yet that can scale to the unlimited number of sessions. So that's a concern, of course, how big the device should be in that case, and how many you should have them, because you don't have the unlimited resources. You could put another device and lower the amount of flows per device to make it scalable, but of course then again it's more expensive to deploy, and so that's an issue, that you would have a lot of session states and all of the network, and you would normally search for it, wouldn't like it. But as long as this solution is perhaps needed, it could be inevitable as well. DS Lite was described here as well, it's using soft wires, so it's not a typo, it's a soft wire between the CPE device and the large scale NAT or carrier NAT in a core network, where IPv4 addresses at home could use that as a tunnel mechanism through the IPv6 access network. So if, as a service provider could start deploying a new network with IPv6 only, but then again you could have a lot of organizations or small businesses or home offices using IPv4 only, then you could use the DS Lite in that case. Then in that case you would have only one level of NAT compared to the previous 444 version. And then the A plus P, which is and of course going back to the previous slide, this and the previous slide would mean that you need to upgrade the CPE device, the current CPE spec. I haven't seen that many CPE devices yet who actually support the DS Lite and that function. And same with the latest technologies, is the idea that you borrow, because you have 16 bits, 65,000 or something ports for applications, so you could borrow a couple of the bits to be used for that customer. If you use these bits extended from, or the borrow from the port, with the IP address, you could use the same IP address with different port values with another customer. So you can actually reuse the IP addresses and then make them that way more unique. Here's a problem as well, how to calculate what is the minimum amount of ports available per customer then. If I have only my Google Maps application at home, I know that I could use a couple of tens or maybe 100 ports or systems at the same time with my PC. But maybe my neighbor or a bigger company with a lot of employees could use more. So that's a risk. Taking on a few bits to be borrowed and still be sure that you don't run out of systems available for customers. And in Japan, they have made some that's available if you write this down. Discussion about how to use this DSLi and address and port sharing thing as an idea and how it would work, etc. And they speculate the amount of sessions needed per user and how well it would work if you have such amount of bits per and you extend the ports or addresses to a certain level and you make some calculation and go down with 5,000 ports or 500 ports or only 10 ports like this example. And so you have 10 TCP sessions in a Google Map application, you would get a lot of error messages. You couldn't get all these details in a map. So you may have noticed when you download a map from Google Maps or in Finland, any of your map, you look into that, it loads the page actually in different sections, and it means that you have a certain amount of sessions where it says the schedule of the map, and that is actually consuming a lot of sessions. And then again, it's a risk of ISP to choose that service, but this could be the result. So, what else? I have a few slides. Juniper has been using IPv6 in its routers since 2001, and that's almost 9 years ago, almost a whole decade. All the routers that we sell for the service providers are always hardware-based, so IPv6 have been since then, IPv6 in hardware enabled. And for a long time, especially in the academic and research world, Juniper has almost been the de facto choice for IPv6 and education and university background vendor, especially in Europe. And, a couple of our paying customers listed, and as a summary, IPv4 exhaustion is actually pushing and making the IPv6 to become really well. It's a must, I think. Nobody can anymore avoid it. So unless somebody creates something creative like this. Port bits, borrowing stuff, etc., or ISP shared IPv4 addresses, etc. But in a few years, could be maybe tackled with the fact that the IPv4 addresses are running out. So IPv6 is there. There are some challenges and need some training for people, and planning is essential, as it says here. Any questions?